our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea. See, that's the message of God is saying. Though its water roar and foam, and the mountains quake with their surging, there is a river whose stream made glad the city of God, the holy place where the Most High dwells. God is within her, she will not fall. God will help her at break of day. Nations are in uproar, kingdoms fall. He lifts his voice, the earth melts. The Lord Almighty is with us, and God of Jacob is our fortress. Come and see what the Lord has done, and desolation he has brought on the earth. He makes wars cease to the ends of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters and the spear. He burns the shields with fire. And this is where we're going to focus on verse 10. He says, be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. All right. As a human nature, the hardest thing to do is wait. Right? And many times, when we're waiting, we skip the waiting. When we're, like with our parents, when we were children, every time we ask, Dad, Mom, can you give us this? And when your mom says, and the dad says, wait, no, I can't wait, Mom. I can't wait anymore, Dad. I can't wait anymore, Mom. The same thing with God. When we're waiting, it's too hard for us to wait, so we skip the waiting. And what we do it on our own way. You know what's funny? Because every time we pray, Lord, I want this, and then while you're waiting, just, I can't wait, I'm just going to do this anyway. And most of the time, what happened is, the fruit of our labor is in vain. And sometimes the result of that, sometimes drastic, immediately you will see the fruit of what we have actually, of what we have done. And also many times in the Bible, you can see characters of great men and women in the Bible. Like for example, when Moses went to Mount Sinai and meet the Lord, the people of Israel told to Aaron, create the golden calf for us to worship. We create our own golden calf in a way, when we're waiting, we decided to do, or we, instead of waiting to the presence of the Lord, to the answers of the Lord, we tend to do in our own way. So that's the same thing. We create our golden calf. And we set aside the Lord and focus on what we're going to do. See, the Lord says this message, there's two parts of the message. Be still and know that I am God. Before we understand the first part, we need to look back and check why are we in these circumstances? Because one, it can be God is putting us into a trial or a test of character, test of faith. But it can be a sin as well. Because of your disobedience, you are in this position. And the second part is, I will be exalted among the nations, and I will be exalted in the earth. Now, when God says, be still in times of need, in times of trouble, in times of suffering, even in times of idle. Idle, not necessarily that you're in trouble, but idle can be when you're looking for instructions from the Lord, waiting for instructions, waiting for revelations from the Lord, waiting for a command from the Lord. Now, this message is part of two testimonies that I'm going to present to you. The first one, I know a lot of people, mo- Most of you already heard this testimony when I was in Saudi Arabia. I was in a church waiting for the result of the progressions of my applications in one of the biggest company, international company in Saudi Arabia, which is Tetra Pak. And they provide huge amount of salaries to everyone. And I was part of the music ministry. I was assistant director of the music ministry in our church. And we're doing, it was our fifth anniversary during that time. So I was really busy during that time. But my heart is different. I was just basically doing what I'm being asked to do. But I was only doing it in a sense that because I was trying to ask the Lord for a favor. So it's like, God did this, I'll do this one. You know, so my heart was actually encouraged. I was not even communicating to the Lord. I was there, my physically present. I was doing everything the task that I was supposed to do. I was doing it faithfully, diligently. But my heart is wicked. My heart is basically not with God. I don't have any time to praise and worship in my own time. Because I was so tired already. You know, sometimes we are in this ministry, sometimes we think that we're doing all these things from the Lord, and it seems like we're doing God a favor with our praise and worship. You know, when we read your Bible, when we pray, when we do our praise and worship, devotions, when we go to the service every Sunday, it seems like we're giving God a favor. It shouldn't be that way. The reason why we're here, the reason why God is telling us to be still and wait for Him is because that's God designed us to wait for Him. Wait for His presence or instructions. See what happened to the people of Israel. Because of their disobedience, because they can't wait for the instructions of the Lord, they stayed there for 40 years. And it shouldn't be that long period of time. But because their heart is wicked, just like me, my heart was so wicked during that time. I didn't get the job. I get mad with the Lord. I get angry with the Lord. I curse the Lord. And I was telling the Lord, I am doing all these things to you. I questioned Him. I questioned Him. I said, well, Lord, what about this? I've done this. I'm part of the music team. And I don't have any voice anymore. I'm so tired. I'm doing all these things. I'm just asking you to do it. Why can't you give this to me? Why can't you? And I was telling the Lord, Lord, you're the God who created the heavens and the earth. You should be providing for me. How come you're not providing all these things? And the reason why I want to work with that company is because I want to bring Elizabeth back in Saudi Arabia during that time. And Andre as well. And I was like, God, I'm doing all this thing. I'm sacrificing my time, Lord. But the Lord just basically said nothing. And then one night, I experienced the Lord. And I experienced Him. To the point, I was in my apartment and I was supposed to be a worship. I'm going to lead the worship on Sunday, on Friday, which is Sunday, but basically it's Friday, the weekend in Saudi Arabia. I didn't go anywhere. I stayed in my room. No worship leader in the church. I stayed there because of my rebellious life. I experienced hell. Anywhere I go, it seems like it's so hot. I already stripped my upper garments, my t-shirt. I still feel so hot. You're not perspiring, but it's dry heat. And that's like, it's so uncomfortable. And then the Lord just like, and then that's where the time, that moment in time, I was ready to give my soul to the enemy. That night, I prayed, if the devil is true, I am selling my soul right now. just to get that job. That's how rebellious my heart is. And I guess the Lord is just like, I don't think you know what you're talking about anyway. But let me you experience what you're asking right now. So God, I experienced hell. The fact that you are actually feeling that heat. And it didn't even last for 5 minutes. But the fact I have experienced that, just imagine you will experience that every single day of your life for eternity. And then the Lord just spoke to me and told me, the only reason why you're doing all these things that you have enumerated, every one of them, is because you just want me to provide all these things to you. But you're not really worshiping me. You're not really praising me. You're just doing this just because you want me to. You're asking for a favor. It's like our parents. Sometimes the only time you want to make, you want to make a good thing, you want to make sure that we're doing all these things for our parents just because, so that our parents will reward us. But you're not doing it just because you want to do it. You want to show your love to your parents, but instead you want your parents to show you, just like the story of the two brothers, the prodigal son. The elder one is just there. The only reason why he's there is because that's what he's going to do. He's just showing everything that God, his father is doing. But his heart was not there. He is more lost than his younger brother. And then, that was my heart during the time in Saudi Arabia. And when I met Jesus Christ that time, that was the turning point. I told myself, this is it. And then my salary was this much during that time. I was supposed to get this much during that time. And then the Lord dropped me this much. To the point that, I was barely making it, but I'm still sending money to the Philippines. And I thank God for Elizabeth's family for helping us, even my family for helping us raise and provide finances for Andre and Elizabeth during that time. Now here in New Zealand, I experienced so many things as well. If you notice, I haven't worked for almost for more than a month now. I got redundant with my first job at my Vodafone, and then brand developers, I got redundant again. And then the work that I'm doing with this company, Window Treatments, they decided not to go ahead anymore after 2 months. So I was questioning the Lord. Is this more of a trial, Lord God, or is this any sin that I have committed? It's both. One is a test of faith, the other one is a sin. Sin of not communicating with the Lord. Not so desperate with the Lord again. And I was telling Pastor Abed, I think the Lord missed me so much. That's more than a month now that I'm still not working. Sometimes God will call your attention. Amen. To the point that there's no way, there's no room for you to go. And He will put you in that corner wherever you go, there's nowhere to go except to run to Jesus Christ or to your Father. He put me in that situation. And I was telling the Lord, why did you put me in this situation again? But the Lord just keep on telling me, where is your heart, my son? And I love the fact that the Lord rebuked me this way. You're supposed to be my pastor, my son. You're supposed to be an example. Not only to your love to your wife, but to your children. And God rebuked me that much. And the only difference right now is that I thank God because I was given the time and the opportunity to praise Him, worship Him every single day of our life. I don't know how to play any instruments. I know how to sing. So Elizabeth and I are just going to listen to this word, these songs that I have prepared. And then we're just going to continue to praise and worship the Lord. Worship Him in desperation. And I'm asking the Lord for forgiveness because I need to be desperate for me to worship the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. And for us, when you're waiting, when you are in your situation right now, I don't know what your situation right now, if you're waiting from the Lord for any instructions, but be desperate. But what I'm saying is, do not just be desperate because you're asking for something. Be desperate every single day of your life. Be desperate in the presence of the Lord. Amen. Be desperate in your prayer life. Be desperate. And I thank God because I was so happy because when Deborah says, change your heart. And I was telling the Lord, change my heart, Lord. Change my heart, Lord. Because I don't want to go back to that situation again wherein I'm going to, you know, I would be rebellious to you again. Lord, I don't want to be rebellious anymore. Amen. I am sick and tired of being rebellious to you, Lord. Because the moment I do this one, I will go back to you anyway. Amen. Because there's no place to go. Sorry. Except to you, Jesus. Amen. Where should I run? If I will run to Pastor Tay, he's still going to tell me, go to God. Amen. And if I will run to my wife and cry like a baby, she will tell me, pray. The same thing with Pastor Lovett. Probably she's going to kick me even.
Right.
But sometimes that's who we are. We're so rebellious. And we don't see how many times that God has actually blessed us. We forgot the fact that God has blessed us so many times. You know, even if you're not asking for it, God was just going to give it to you. And you will be surprised. I'm not even asking this. And in the moment when you're asking the Lord for something, and then the Lord will just tell you, son, daughter, be still. You can't even go still. Lord, I want it now. But you see, one thing that I like with the Lord is His timing is always perfect. Always perfect.
Amen.
Kailan pa na delay si Lord sa buhay mo? Lord, the Lord was never delayed in giving you whatever you want. The only reason why you think the Lord is delaying everything is because you want it now. Don't let God, or don't think that God is like a magician and one snap will give everything to you. And sometimes that's who we are. That's how we see the Lord. And that's who we are until when we're actually waiting. We grumble. And the worst thing that we do is not only setting aside the Lord, but doubting what God can do to your life. We doubt that the Lord can do it. When we disobey, when we're asking for something, and then we pray and we sidetrack and we set aside the Lord and we do it in our own way, you know, it's like telling to the Lord, I don't think you can do it, Lord. It's like slapping the Lord in His face. See, the Lord provided. See how Israel was brought out from the from Egypt. They were already crossing the. They were already crossing, but they still grumbling. And they think that the it's like they just Moses is leading us to this place where the Egyptians can actually massacre them. And when they were already in the promised land, they still grumble. Every day God provided manna, and they still grumble. The same thing with us. When we're waiting, when God is telling you to wait, wait, wait. But Lord, I can't wait anymore. And I was telling to myself, Lord, I've been waiting for like 12 months now, for more than a month now, I'm still waiting for a job. 20 plus applications. Everything's denied. Zero. Nothing. But the only thing that I'm doing right now is just basically praise, worship Him. Yes, even though sometimes I'm not perfect, I still like, I can't wait anymore. As much as I want to stay at home and, you know, take care of my children, take care of my wife, I'm a husband. I'm supposed to be the one who provides for my family. I'm supposed to be the one standing and leading my family. But the Lord put me in that situation because God, I believe that God is building my character. The same thing with you. Whatever you are in your situation right now, God is doing something inside of you.
Amen.
Don't just think about your situation. Think about how God. Enjoy your right. Enjoy the moment that your God is being so mindful of you. If the Lord will give you everything that you will provide, you might as well question the Lord now. And if you're not having any trial right now, everything is good on you, you might as well double check if your blessings is still coming from the Lord.
Right.
And double check your heart if it's still correct. Because the moment you keep enjoying it, most of the time, admit it to yourself, and I'm going to admit it to myself, we forgot the Lord. Mm-hmm. And if the more you keep on enjoying your life, the more you enjoy everything, check your heart. Check all your blessings that you're getting right now. It may not be from the Lord. Or probably the Lord is just giving you everything because the Lord says, I will give you the desires of your heart. Yes, God will give you the desires of your heart. How wicked you are, God will give you the desires of your heart. His faithfulness will not change, how wicked you may be. But check your heart. Because God can take that away from you as well.
Amen.
The moment that the Lord will take that away from you, and if your heart is not correct, you will definitely stumble again. Mm-hmm. And the worst thing that can happen, you will get angry with the Lord. And the worst thing that can happen to you when you get angry with the Lord is you will stop praising, worshiping, understanding who God is. And you will just turn away and forget about your God. And forget about what the Lord has done into your life. And you know what will happen? The enemy will rejoice. The enemy will welcome you. And the more the enemy will welcome you, the more the enemy will put words into your mind. And the enemy will tell you, I can do all these things to you. I can make you happy. happiness can be, there's difference between happiness and joy. There's a difference between achieving peace and achieving your like being idle. I forget the word, but there's a difference with that. Anything that is coming from the Lord lasts forever.
Amen.
Anything that is coming from the enemy will last just for a short term. You know, in Genesis, God promised Abraham and Sarah that they would have a multitude of descendants. So he was faced by a huge obstacle because Abraham is old, Sarah is barren. When he and Sarah got tired of waiting for God to make good in his promise, they tried to overcome the obstacle on their own. And we know the story of that. As a result, they fractured their family and created a lot of unnecessary disagreement. Nothing that Abraham did in his own strength worked, just like us. Nothing works. Because we get tired of waiting. We skip the waiting. And the more we skip, the more we get confused. The more we do, we add up with the confusions, the more we ended up doing so many things. Rather than if you just wait, you will just gonna be probably in 10, you know, probably in a week time, you should have your blessings already. But because you've done so many things, the Lord will send, will put you in this, oh, okay. Do you want 2 months of no job? Do you want 3 months, son? I can give that to you, you know. I can wait. You know, that's how gentle the Lord is. He's not gonna do any, he's not gonna, unless otherwise, you know. He's not gonna do anything. Okay, you want 3 months? Oh, fine. If you want 40 years, no more, that's fine. I can wait. That's what he done to the Israelites. He was obedient. You know, the Lord keeps on blessing them. Okay, manna every day, manna every day. That's what you deserve, manna only. Because you're so disobedient. Do you want manna every day for 40 years? Lord, you have to do something about it. You know, the same thing with Abraham. You see, he's the father of all nations. He's a man who is, he was actually a man of great faith. But he stumbles. I'm not saying you need to be Abraham in order for you to have great faith. There's only one Abraham. Yes. There's only one Nick. There's only one Tita Grace. We're created by the Lord, you know, differently. But remember the DNA of Abraham. In the DNA that is flowing in your body comes from the Lord.
Amen.
The anointing of Abraham is the same as your anointing. There's no such thing as great anointing from Pastor Ben because he's a prophet.
Yes.
The anointing is the same.
Amen.
Not because he's a prophet and Pastor Job is a pastor, that doesn't mean that their anointing is different from Tita Grace or Deuteronomy.
Amen.
The anointing is the same. Because we're serving the same God.
Amen.
Bless God.
Yeah, the only thing is from the prayer life.
Yeah.
Our prayer life, my prayer life. You know, like sometimes we're like this. Probably they're like more of, you know. But don't just compare yourself.
Don't think that
oh, Pastor Ben probably the reason why she's always in prayer because she's not working. I'm not even working. But my prayer life is not the same as
yes,
her. I know. But to continue. So nothing that Abraham did But ultimately, he became known as a man of a tremendous or great faith. The Apostle Paul wrote of him, against all hope, Abraham in hope believed and so became the father of many nations. So just like Abraham, so what happened? God provided the son to Abraham. God will answer all our prayers. But we just have to be still. We just have to wait. Don't just rush God. Because remember the Bible says His ways are greater than our ways. His thoughts are higher than our thoughts. Probably our 1 week can be 1 minute from the Lord. You don't know. But the more we wait, and right now I was telling to myself, the more I was telling my Elizabeth, when I stop working, I'm going to miss this. Because every morning, we praise and worship in the morning. In the evening, we praise and worship in the evening. That's the only thing I do. That's the only thing we do. But I was telling the Lord, Lord, I don't want to come to that point when you give me that job that I will not do this anymore. That I will don't have that time anymore. Please, Lord, I was telling the Lord, please don't let me. But I'm not telling the Lord, please don't let me, don't give me job first. So I want to enjoy the ride. No, I'm enjoying the ride right now. But I know that the Lord has promised me something. Whatever that promise is, I'm just going to claim it. Because I don't know if the Lord will send us somewhere or if I'm going to work here. I don't know. But what I'm trying to tell you guys is that enjoy your ride with the Lord. Enjoy every minute of it. Because when you're enjoying that ride, the feeling is so good. You know, the Bible says in Matthew, but seek first the kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. While waiting, that's what Matthew says. But seek first the kingdom of God. That was the command of the Lord. Seek. You have to seek first the Lord. While waiting, be still is a command from the Lord. And seek first the kingdom of God. Our God is not only God that we need, we read in the Bible. A God of history. He's our very present help, our fortress, our rock. He just wants you to trust Him, allow Him to be the God that He's supposed to be. Remember His ways, like I said, He's greater than us. And His timings are always perfect. And I will leave you with this verse that my wife just mentioned anyway. That's why I was like, when Elizabeth just mentioned that verse, I was like, Lord, thank you. Because we are actually in one heart right now, in one, you know, like everything that is happening from prayer, from the opening prayer to today, the Lord was just telling us one message only. Jeremiah 29, for I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Then you will call on me and come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. He will listen to you. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart. The key to seek God is with all your heart. Don't just seek God because you're looking for something or you want something from the Lord. Seek God because that's what you want. Seek God because He deserved it. And I'll say it before and I say it again. The reason why you are here, the reason why God created us, is not only to subdue the earth, but to give praise and worship Him. Yeah. It's not just the angels who will continue to praise and worship the Lord. It's us. We're far special from any creations of the Lord. God wants to have a communion with you, wants to communicate with you, than all the animals in this place, than the angels. He wants to communicate with you. He wants to talk to you personally. He wants to have a one-on-one with you. If you have time today, sit down. Don't do anything. And just open your heart. Your entire being, open it to the Lord. I will guarantee you, you will feel the hug and the love of God.
Amen.
I'll guarantee that. And whatever load that you're carrying right now, God will just remove everything. And when you sit down, I will challenge you, when you sit down, don't think about your situations. Set aside everything that is happening into your life right now. And just have that moment that God deserved from you. Exalt His name, because He deserved that exaltation.
Yes.
Have that moment. Probably you can ask me, how long do I need to do this?
Mm-hmm.
Until such time you feel the presence of the Lord. Until such time you feel the presence of the Lord. But I'm telling you, this man and woman of great faith have done it. And I can say that I've done it. Because I enjoy my ride with the Lord. I am enjoying that ride, that moment. And I thank God for this family, this church. And I thank God for I have pastors who support me. I have a wife who supports me, who understands me. And I thank God for those people who pray. And I thank God and I honor God for allowing me to have that right. Because it was so awesome.
Amen.
It was so good.
Amen.
But don't do what I'm doing. But don't think that you need to, you know, don't think that you have to have no job first before you enjoy the ride, okay? Or don't just disobey the Lord first before you enjoy the ride. Enjoy the ride right now. You don't need to be disobedient, okay? That's not the key. The key right now is to enjoy the ride. Okay? Let me all stand up.